the LIM Fair.
ARDA advertised it as a good old-fashioned small-town get-together, a miniature world fair of sorts for the hard-working government employees and their families that lived in Sierra Town. The flyers and brochures I've gotten my hands on promised all manner of things, mundane and fantastical. Kiss your low-tech washing machine goodbye. Take home this LIM nebulizer and zap your clothes and diapers clean. Why break your back trimming your lawn when LIM Tech can transform your grass into something more? This push to get LIM Tech into the homes of zone residents, housewives in particular, was a deliberate and strategic move. The cynical reason, and most popular interpretation, is that it was a PR push to rehabilitate LIM Tech's image. By 1973, there'd been enough reports of radioactive fallout and inexplicable disappearances that suspicion of what ARDA was doing was high. Where were you when the CRM incident happened?
At base camp, about 20 miles out of town. The sirens went off during dinner.
We barely had time to wonder whether it was a drill or real before the shockwave rolled through. Luckily, we'd been through the disaster procedure days before. We dove under our tables to take cover. And we were just kids, and at first thrilled for the drama unfolding in real time. It was hours before ARDA came to extract us. By that time, we'd scrambled up onto a hill to signal for help and saw
Take your time.
It's been 20 years and I still can't go anywhere near a county fair of any sort.
What did they tell you had happened?
Nothing. They were all business. Hurrying us onto the trucks with boarded up windows. We weren't even allowed back in our cabins to pack our belongings. They breezed us out of the zone.
It wasn't until days later when most of us were deposited in an orphanage that we learned that our parents died.
Lisa's account is one of the most damning and holds up to the best of my verification efforts. She's told that story many times and hadn't changed this story in the ensuing years. Chalk it up to good memory or deeply seated trauma, but it is, as far as I can tell, real. The stories from others, however, inspire a healthy dose of skepticism. Those who weren't too scared of government retaliation were few. And the ones who shared their stories loved their 15 minutes of fame a little too much. Any talk show or gossip rag or cheap date willing to listen heard from these types and made piecing together the zone's true history for someone like me, decades later,
a migraine-inducing experience. Because these stories, as every good gossip knows, morphed over time. What started as the most powerful lightning storms recorded on Earth turned into UFOs touching down. An innocent spiderweb became something to be avoided on pain of death. A grassy lawn, left untended, became a feeding ground for something called burp bunnies. The tales became taller as the years went by, and the more I heard, the more my suspension of disbelief left me. And while the Sierra disaster was only one of the many incidents that occurred over the Zone's 32-year history, it is the one I return to as a prime example. Whatever happened there in Sierra is the type of disaster that caused the creation of the Exclusion Zone in the first place. We can extrapolate from what little we know of what happened here.
If this is the one story to get out, how many more horrors did LIM technology cause?
Thank you. You're not the first to try crossing the old wall since the anomalies moved in. But we'll make sure you're the first to survive. Two things to keep in mind. First,
to get through the old wall, there are 5 crossing points. You need to induce the electrical grid the entire way by driving the car close enough and fast enough along the conductors. You'll see them as you go. Once you jumpstart the grid, Tobias will route the midzone power your way, but no induction,
no power, no power, no crossing. Second, watch your battery gauge. You will live or die by that thing. Got it? Good. Start by connecting the power grid at the first crossing point. The controls will be up in the observation tower.
shuttle stops at each crossing point. Use them to recharge your battery and hope they're still in working condition after all these years.
Thank you. on that one. Try again, driver.
How's the power routing?
Well, the neighbors are complaining about the flickering lights, but I told them to light some candles and sit tight.
Francis?
Levels are good, holding steady. Circuit complete. Keep it up, driver. Tobias, the power supply is wavering.
I'm working on it. Our local battery farm is putting up a fuss. She hasn't been taxed like this in a while, but I'm easing her into it. Don't worry. the connection. Speed up and you've got it.
Farms 1 through 3 are reporting total power drain. They're spent.
How long to recharge?
Could take up to a day.
No, no, I got this.
From Battery Farm 6.
Easy. Too much and you'll blow out your control center.
Too little and the entire array's going down. We have no choice.
Thank you.
Give us the signal, Tobias! Tobias? Stay with us.
I got you, Omni. Friends? Well, what do you know? One time, I tried myself out of things to say. Omni, take care of him for me.
Tobias!
Friends, I love you forever.
I love you forever.
Online. Francis, now!
Tobias, answer me.
Tobias, answer me!
Don't do it! You can't go out there! Driver, the power's holding steady. You can open that final gate!
Got scrambled in instability. I'm afraid, Tobias.
I told you. I told you, didn't I? We weren't ready. We should have planned it better. We should have known.
We did the best we could.
No. Do not give me that. If we had, he'd be here with us.
I'm sorry, but we've got to help the driver.
Don't you dare. What? Wait, is this how you dealt with Alan's death? You put your head down and let work fill the gaps?
Actually, that's precisely what I did. And you'll recall the breakthrough in self-healing materials that I made that year.
Oh, well, good for you. I'm sure Alan would have been very proud of you using his death that way.
You know what? That whole pep talk I gave you before to convince you to go through with it. That's precisely the same crap Alan would tell me all the time.
It's worth the sacrifice. Stay late, don't worry about me. Finish your work, then we can start a family. Always he'd spew that crap.
So why'd you say it to me?
Because he has to have been right. Because if I let myself think he was wrong, then... I can't live with that regret. I gave everything for them. This is the last thing I'm holding on to for myself. Every single day, I still think about how if I had left the zone when we had planned to, I wouldn't have lost Alan. I thought, I hoped, that Lim Tech was done killing our own. I'm sorry about Tobias.
Tobias is... was... all I had. I need to sign off for a while.
We'll be here when you're ready. Glad you got through, driver. Power on that stabilizer, and I'll see you back at the garage. welcome back. Now we know where the well is. But you're the first to step foot in the deep zone in over 15 years. And I need more time to understand Alan's suppression method. So why don't you stretch your legs and chart the deep zone while you're at it? We'll need to map a way to the well as it is.